Hi guys. Oh, I've had a quiet day. I've rested my ankles mostly. Felt like a sack of crap earlier, but I think I can put it down to white bread and too much of it. I've got a feeling the gluten in it is too much for my poor tummy, so I think I'm going to have to concede defeat and stick to wholemeal. Anyway, when I was feeling better, because I had what I call one of my sort of spells, where I just, I had to dash to the loo for a dump because I had the squits. Then I had the tummock. What the fuck's a tummock? And then I had the tummy pains again. I felt like my guts were on fire and got the shivers a little. Not a great deal, but a little. A little bit nauseous, but again, wasn't vomiting or anything. Never have done. And took a glass of water, had an antacid, because I could feel a little bit of heartburn there from dinner, because I hadn't long eaten dinner. And about an hour and a half, back to normal, as I am now. So I decided to recase my Windows 7 PC. And I've got most of the connections made. I'm not sure if I have to connect these for the fan or if I can just rely on this one. I've got three things plugged together there. One is just an adapter for Molex to SATA for the DVD drive, because I only had the one cable and it would only go down to the hard drive, which I think is in backwards, but that's the only way I can get the damn thing to fit so I can get the side covers on. Front fan's connected there to a Molex. There is another cable connected to the board fan connector. But I think aside from the USB 3 connector, which this motherboard doesn't have compatibility for, I'm not sure I've got a motherboard that does, everything's connected and I can power it on whenever I'm ready. Although I did take those 3 feet off and then I've realised I've got no ventilation under the bottom here for the power supply, so if I do set this up somewhere, I'm going to have to sit this on like a couple of, I don't know, little blocks or something, just so there's enough gap there for airflow. Otherwise, I'm going to overheat the power supply. And I don't particularly want to kill a 550 watt power supply. I didn't think of that when I took the feet off, but I only had 3 feet anyway, so it wasn't sitting level. I suppose I could. Can't remember if I've actually thrown them now, but if I've still got them, I could just pop the rear two on so it's sat like that. That gives some airflow at least. I think if I could find something, just like a little narrow wooden block or something, just to stick in there, that'll do for now. No, one at the front and one probably somewhere here, or even right at the back, just so it would sit level. But apart from that, I haven't haven't done a lot today. I did go to Cats from Cats Custom Trikes yesterday and got my uniform, which the cat is currently sitting on, just like her cat had slept on it. There's something about cats and my clothes, isn't there, boy? Eh? You like sleeping on my clothes? He does. If I leave a coat somewhere, he'll sleep on that as well. No idea why. I don't know if it's because it's got my scent on it or I don't know. Well, they haven't got my scent on it because I haven't worn them yet. But on the way back from Cats yesterday, Cat came with me because I forgot to take the bloody bike seat with me to put on her bike. Took everything else I needed apart from the bike seat. But Yeah. We got a couple of miles from hers and I got a puncture. So we had to walk. Well, Kat didn't. She could have ridden if she really, really wanted to, but she didn't. She said she didn't feel right riding alongside me while I had to walk all the way. So we both walked 6-7 miles all the way back to mine. Took us 3 hours or so, because we had to stop a few times. And my ankles are, well, actually they're not as bad now, but when I first got up they were rather sore. I did say to her I'd feel it today. That's got to be the furthest I've walked in a long time. But I did try to fix the puncture today. I put a new tube in. Checked the tire first for anything sharp in it. Couldn't feel anything. So I put the tube in, pumped it up. I went downstairs a few hours later to put the bike in the shed, and it was flat as a pancake again. So there's an issue there somewhere that's puncturing my tubes. So I think instead of do the quick, you know, finger test where you run your fingers around the inside of the tire to feel for anything sharp, I'm going to have to take the tire off and give it a good thorough check, and the wheel rim, because there could be something wrong with the wheel rim. If I can actually pump up the tubes and find out where the hole is. Why has this just gone out of focus? No. Thank you. Just got this habit of doing whatever it likes. Anyway, yeah, so I'm going to have to, I might do that tomorrow, because I'm not going to Mum's tomorrow. Hopefully Sunday. No recycling centre trip this weekend, because I'm skint till Thursday. So, joy! I really could do a selling that kid's bike. But, never mind.
I am feeling so tired.
Well, I haven't slept very well the past couple of nights anyway. I had wanted to put at least the t-shirt on and show myself wearing it, but I'm not going to disturb the cat. I haven't got the heart to disturb my cat. Can you tell who's the boss in this flat? He is. Yes, you. Love you. Can I see him? Can we see him? I think you can see him over there. Can't see bugger all on the screen. Oh, yes, I can. Oh, dear. According to a Facebook post I saw earlier, there was some scallywags in town. Young scallywags. Don't know how young, but someone on my friends list put up that she'd just driven through town, and a large group of youths just stepped out in front of a car. Then I believe she said she went round again. No, it was someone else had seen them and seen two other cars that had pulled over and stopped to confront them, and they were giving them, the kids were giving these people that had stopped a load of verbal. So yeah, lovely sort of people, aren't they? I don't see why some youths have got to do that. I never, you know, went around town with a group of, you know, friends from school or whatever, you know, just randomly giving people verbal for the sheer hell of it. I know I wasn't a saint, but that was one thing I never did. I don't think any of us are a saint when we're kids. We're always getting up to mischief, but there's several things I never did. You know, I never prank called the emergency services either. Never prank called anyone, actually. But most of the time I was at home anyway, so.
Oh, here we go.
Phew. Right. I think tomorrow night's video I'm going to make of me taking the guts out of this one and putting in the now empty case in the kitchen. The little silver one, silver and black one, Asus case, that's it. That my Windows 7 was in before I now put it in its new case. And then I'll leave this big one free for me to build something else into. I'm not sure what yet. Probably a Windows 7 PC, because I haven't got anything higher than Windows 7. I haven't. Windows 7 is the highest operating system I've got. Did have Windows Vista. I know, that's lower, isn't it? That was before 7. But I don't have 8 or 8.1 or anything like that. I don't think I'd want them anyway. I don't like it. I don't know what I'm going to do for the rest of the evening. Might put GTA on for a little while and blow some shit up, because that seems to be all I did. Actually, last night I managed to get a 5-star wanted level. I was holding the cops off for quite a while, probably due to the hiding place I took. Because the hiding place I got Trevor into was on a roof behind this sort of wall thing, so no foot police could actually get to him. It was only the helicopters, so it was quite easy to stay alive for quite a while. Until a police officer managed to abseil down from a helicopter right behind me without me noticing, and he took me out. But yeah, I did manage to get a 5-star wanted level. I do like that. It just challenges myself and my own skill to see how long I can survive before the inevitable is going to happen. Because once you've got, in my experience, once you've got, well, you can get rid of a 4-star wanted level, but it ain't easy. But I've never managed a 5-star wanted level, not to get rid of it. I've actually never managed to get a 5-star wanted level. That was the first time. I must have the camera on. Jesus, your nose is cold, and that tickled my arm. I could probably very easily nod off like this.
Okay.
Right. Leave my drinks alone. Do not want your fluff in my drink. I don't mind about the glass of water, just don't get it in my Coke. Right. I'm just running things around in my head to make sure there isn't anything I've missed that I wanted to mention in this vlog. Nothing that I can think of at the minute. Not unless you want me to sort of describe how it was when I went to the loo earlier, you know, I could do that, but I don't think anyone would want to know that. I don't know what it is. He's always lovey like this at night. Never during the day. Never. That's just something about... Can you get comfortable? That's just... Something about night time with him. During the day, he's asleep. Oh, the battery's gonna die, so I'm gonna have to end this then. So, thanks for watching. I've got nothing else to talk about anyway, so don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And thanks in advance for those to those who do. And I'll talk to you again soon. Bye. Hi guys. It's 20 to 5 in the afternoon, on a Saturday afternoon. And I decided to have a bit of a lay-in, so I didn't get my arse out of bed until 11 o'clock. Something like that. And I just waited for Mum to turn up this afternoon, and we went round town. Got a few bits and whatnot. Reminds me of one of these lemonades in the fridge. I might sound a bit out of breath because I've just come up the stairs. I'm trying to get a pedal off that sabotaged bike. The one that's not broken will come off. Sod's law says that the one that is broken doesn't want to come off. That is stuck on there solid. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that one yet. If I could find an aluminium pedal arm that looks reasonably similar, then I'll just swap that pedal arm. So when I get a chance, I'm going to go digging in my cupboard and see if I've got one. As long as it looks similar, I'm not fussed whether it's an exact match. But, it's been a pain in the backside. I've just stuck a couple of calipers on here loosely for now, because I want to know if they'll hit the rims. Yes, they will reach the rims, so I've got to lower the brake blocks, but I've got to replace the two in that back caliper anyway, so I'm going to go ahead later and bolt the calipers on properly, because And I thought I need a rear reflector on this, but then I realised the rack is in the way, so I can't put it in its traditional place. So, and there's no bracket on the back of the rack either, so I'm a bit stumped on what I'm going to do there. I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to get the cables connected, and then I'm going to, well, actually first I'm going to tackle this bloody thing. I must have turned the camera on, because here comes Nemaho. Right, yeah. Put a new tube in this tyre yesterday. Stupid thing. It's gone down again. I haven't done any more on the computers, but I will be later, and I will be adding it to this video. But I have hit a little snag. This 12-volt cable for the motherboard, it's too tight, I can't get my video card back in. So I'm not sure how I'm going to get over that yet. I'm going to have to look on the bottom shelf in this cupboard and see if I've got a power supply that's got a longer cable. Because I don't really want to splice into it and butcher it and lengthen it if I don't have to. This one's perfectly fine, I can get the video card under that, but that one, no chance. And I don't even think I've got a chance of rerouting it, to be honest. Otherwise I'd try that. I think it's going to be tight no matter what I do. I might try and reroute it, if I can get it off the board, because that's quite a tight fit up the top there. Unplug it, put the video card in, that way I'll know roughly how much slack I'm going to need, aren't I? And where I can reroute it to. Is that all lined up? Yes, so I'll just go ahead and push it. There we go. Okay, so my mains cable is fine. I'm just going to whack a screw on that just to hold the video card in place. Perhaps I should have put the kitchen light on, because I'm getting in my own light. I'm sort of relying on the kitchen window. Let's give you a slightly better view, shall we? I'll just sit you on there for a moment. while I struggle to get this screw in. It probably didn't help that the back was a little bit warped. There we go. I don't know whether to leave. I don't want to leave that where it is, this power cable, because it's not really in the way there. You see, I could route it around the back if I wanted to, but it's just this one that's being the pain. It's got to go up. Yeah, and even if I went round, oh, that's yards too short. That's yards too short that way. There's a hole down there, but I'm not even sure this is going to reach if I stuck it up through there either. Can I just trim that off? Yep. Right. So now I've got, I think, yes, I think that's the one. Well, that got up through there. And a bit of a jiggling around, it might. Go on, up we go. This is that's an absolute tight fit. I've actually managed to do it. It's gone through there. Putting in PCI slot cards might be an issue. Oh, I don't know. Yeah, it might be. But I think that's about all that I can muster up at the moment. Where's my processor fan unplugged? I'm glad I spotted that. I don't remember unplugging it, but that was off. Unless I accidentally caught it. And that wouldn't have been good, powering this up without the fan on. Well, that wouldn't have hurt it for a few seconds, but it probably wouldn't do it a lot of good. Right, that sort. So later on, I'm ready to turn this on, I think, and make sure it's all working, but first I'm going to try and find out why, or rather what's puncturing that tube. There's either something stuck in this tire still that I missed. Hang on. Oh. No, that's just a stone stuck in the tread. That was nothing to worry about. Oh yeah, I was playing with memory cards on the cameras earlier. You fucking focus, you piece of shit. What did that zoom in like that? No idea. It was, unless I hit the zoom accidentally, it may have zoomed in all by itself. Anyway, as I was saying, I managed to get my 8 megabyte memory card that I was using in that one to register in this one. So that's now on photograph duty, and between this Panasonic and that Vivitar, that will be video duty. Anyway, I'm going to disappear because I've got things I need to get done. I'm going to investigate this tire and wheel, see if I can find out exactly where that bloody... exactly where it's getting punctured from, so I can solve the problem. And hopefully I've got another fully pumped up tube in a wheel in the bedroom. But obviously I don't want to pop another tube, so I'm going to have a look. There may have even been a spoke pop through the rim tape for all I know, and I didn't notice it. But anyway, I'm going to do that, and I'll come back later on. Just want to update quickly. I've put a new tube and tyre on the back wheel. put the Continental Vapor back on, and I'm going to get the other tyre and put back on the front wheel. Well, that tyre actually came with the wheel, so did the inner tube, but I cannot find anything in that tyre that's puncturing it. But the puncture in this tube is on the outside of the tube. It's on, there's the valve that goes on the inside. It's on this side of the tube, which indicates it's come from the tyre, not the wheel rim. So, I mean, that was a good tube until I put it in that wheel and it punctured it again. So I figured I'll put my Vapors back on, my Continental Vapor tyres. So I'm going to have to go digging in the cupboard, aren't I? Actually, I shouldn't have to dig too much. Is that the one? No. Here we go. Oh, you can see it. I found it. I may end up with a wheel in my face though. I don't want the inner tube, it's got a slight puncture. Oops. Couple of tubes up there, I don't know if they're punctured, I can't remember. Tomorrow as well. I'm just getting a few things out ready. Pump these tubes up and see if they are punctured. I don't think they are. Tube in it as well. I'll pump that one up. Oh, actually, I don't think I'll have to pump that tube up. I've got to take the whole tyre and tube out anyway, because I've got nothing out there. Toolbox out later. Mum just said give her a ring when I'm ready. Anyway, I'm gonna go down before it gets too dark, throw this wheel back in, pump it up, change the tyre on the front wheel, and then I'll come back upstairs and might get a bite to eat, I don't know yet, but talk to you in a little while. Okay, I'm back in the kitchen, obviously. I'm not gonna give system a test, whoops, test well, make sure it still works. Plug the monitor in, that will help. Switch that on. Oh, it's up here. And we have nothing. Why do we have nothing? We have nothing, people, we have fail. Right. We not done something right here, have I? It actually looks like it goes on the end of something, that one. Anyway, I've got a feeling it could be that I've got the power switch and whatnot round the wrong way. I'm going to need some sort of light. There it is. It's got a magnet on the back, so I'll have to keep that away from the thingy, hard drive. What did I do with the magnifying glass last time I had it? Used it for something because I was looking at something. I can't remember what I've done with it. Might not need it. I might be able to get away with it. Okay. Just park you there for a minute. I'll turn the switch off, and I so. Oh, you know what would actually help if I turn it on at the wall? I'm hoping that was a self-power-on test. Or maybe not, so maybe I have got some wires crossed. Let's have a look-see. Oops. Yeah, I have. I've got a few wires. Here's the smidge of the wrong place. Oopsie daisy. I'm just going to plug that for a moment. It's turned. Yeah, I've got it turned off. I'm sorry. I've got better. Oops. Work, is it? I don't mind. Well, with a bit of light on here, I can actually see what I'm doing. Ah, that's why. Nothing actually lines up with what it's meant to be. Right. That's reset switch. That's hard drive LED. That's power switch, right. Reset goes at the bottom. I'm going to do the bottom ones first, because they're the hardest to get to. Especially if you put the top ones on first. That's hard drive LED. I don't want that one. I just want power switch. I'm going to leave the LEDs off just for the moment. Right, so I've got those plugged in. There we go. Did you get anything out on the PC? Oh, here we go. As long as it boots up, I'll shut it down and proceed to put the thingies on. Front fan's working. Oh, we have a fan off at the top. That one's working though. It's an exhaust fan. We've got the front. That's sucking in. If I can actually get the other fan to work when I figure out what cable does what. I wonder if that plastic cover comes off so I can trace the cables. Did I password this one? Don't remember passwording it, but obviously I did. Well, that's good, it's working at least. Right. Yeah, got that fan right there. White one's spinning nicely, black one isn't. Ah, black one. I can see yellow, red, and black. So that's going to this one. Maybe it's not working. I may try another Molex. Okay, what device is ready to use? What did you just install? Oh, well. Who gives a monkeys? Oh, isn't that mouse working well? No. Doesn't work the worktop, so I'm going to use it on my jeans instead. Right, I'm going to shut you down. And the power supply fan does light up. That's good. It's working at least. I've got the front fan, I've got one top fan which is exhaust. Right, I'm going to shut the camera down. Just touch up what I've got to do in here with the cables and whatnot and double check everything, and I can get organised and set up for the next project. So I'll be back in a little while. For a second there, I forgot where the stop button was. Okay, scrubbed the idea of transferring the Windows XP. I've got other plans for that one though. I forget I put two hard drives in this one. Therefore, I can't put it in that one because there's only room for one hard drive. So, but I do want to change the motherboard in this one. Pardon me. Yeah, the motherboard is going to be changed. Haven't decided what board I'm going to put in there yet, but it will be changed eventually. But yeah, I've got the other one done, everything's all connected. Except I forgot the card reader. And it was a hassle to get that frickin' side panel on there, but yeah. I'll do that later on. I'll take that to Mum's tomorrow. I've decided that's the front wheel I'm going to use. Don't need to change the front wheel, but it's either that or it's going to look like a pair of wheels like that. You know, one silver, one black, so I figured I might as well just... As the back one's black, and about the only decent spare back wheel I've got is also black, I'm just going to stick with black wheels. I'm still having no luck with the Claude. Swapped all the tyres over, fine. Pumped them up, went for a little ride. Tyre went flat. Which means I've got a problem with the rim somewhere. There's something on that rim that's going into the tube. Now, I could, if I really wanted to, go downstairs and pull the wheel out again, bring it up here and see if I can find out what's causing it on the rim, or I could just leave it for another day because I don't really need it right this minute. I'm going over to Mum's tomorrow, so I'll probably bring one, maybe two bikes back. Or maybe three, it just depends how I feel. Might throw three in the car. Is that dirt on the lens? It is, isn't it? Hang on a minute. Oh, well, it looks like if it goes too dark, it stops recording. As that is exactly what it just now did. I didn't know that. I just cleaned the lens off a little bit anyway, it looked a bit mucky. Right. I'm in the mood for putting things together now. But I'm not in the mood for doing flat tires. Flat tire can bloody sit down now, that bike's pissing me off at the minute. So, yeah, don't know what to do with computers. I could just quickly throw in the card reader, or that's something I could do tomorrow night as well, I suppose. Yeah, right, so what shall I do tonight? Well, that proves I didn't have to do a tyre change then, did I? Because it wasn't the tyre. I'll leave the Continentals on there now. I'll save this pair for another bike. I don't know what I was doing with the camera there. That was all under wonk. Pardon me. mate. I'm not drinking Coke either at the minute. Because I ain't got any. Right. I'm just deciding what to do next, that's all. I need rim tape on that black wheel down there, on that front one. I'm going to pump a couple of tubes up, because if I could actually assemble it, so I just got to swap the wheels, and that'd make my... That's my shoulder when you... No, that's my nose. You finished? Good. Just get distracted by the cat. You hear it? Anyway, I'm going to pump a couple of tubes up, and if they've gone down by morning, then I won't use them. But if they stay inflated, I'll assemble that front wheel, so when I get to Mum's, all I've got to do is throw it in the bike. That's the plan. I'm going to pump them up with my foot pump as well before I take them over. I don't think that bike actually needs much else, to be honest. Anyway, I'm going to do that, and I'll be back later. Okay, as you can see, I've been busy doing something. Got brake cables on it. They're connected. They're functioning, but they're just not set up yet. Because I've got to change the front wheel. And... I need a brake block in the back of this one, because there's one missing. But yeah, they do both spring and function fine. So it's getting there. Bring that wheel back tomorrow. Plonk in the front. I'm going to pump those tubes up in a little bit. See what goes down overnight, if any. Because I'm going to need it, possibly a couple at Mum's tomorrow. Got some stuff down there I need to take to Mum's. That wheel, the black one. I'll take those tyres as well. So for the gear cable, I'm going to do it the easy way. I just use the one long length of outer, just because I actually haven't got no bolt-on cable guides or anything to do it the fancy way, we'll call it. It's going to work just as well. Might want an outer a little bit longer than that though. I don't know. I've got one. I'll just have to unravel what I've got up here and have a look, you know. It may not be white like the others, actually I think it will be, because I don't think that's going to be long enough. Yeah, well, we can guess what I've been doing. Apart from that, I've not done a lot tonight. I'm actually feeling rather bored. It's now 11 o'clock. I think I'm going to bag a few bits up, get the toolbox sorted. I've got a couple of tools up here that I need to throw back in here. I was going to say there's some missing, but no, there isn't. They're in the lid of the toolbox itself. Someone's got a screw. Screw that down so I can get it into the lid of the toolbox. I've just got to throw a load of screwdrivers missing, the wire cutters, blah blah blah. easier to do it this way instead of trying to think, what tools do I need? Well, there's tools in the workshop, but it's just a case of trying to find the damn things. And it's just as easy if I have this toolbox, because I can just plonk outside by the back door or wherever I'm working, and I've got the tools there. I haven't got to keep running back and forth to the bloody workshop to find them. And then bitch because I can't find them. Because stepdad's had them. I know. He does. We do the same with each other. We'll have used tools and we'll forget to put them back or whatever. And he'll go looking for something and then start moaning because I haven't put it back. And I'll do the same thing. It's really uncanny that we are so alike in that sense. Take these tools through. Not doing anything related to that. And I actually think I might invest. Those on there. And another one of those packs of keyring torches, which I've got one up here somewhere. I need to give one to Mum. There was one up here somewhere, unless I've pushed it behind the computer case. Just so I can keep one in my toolbox, so I've got a little light there, just in case I need one. Because you never know when you're going to come up against something, you know, where you can't quite see, especially with me. And they're so small and compact, they'll slide into one of the compartments at the top there, actually, quite nicely. No doubt Lidl's will have plenty in stock. Oh, it's on the floor. I might as well throw that in the top then. And if I find them both, I'll throw both and give the other one to Mum. Then I'm going to get myself another pair. And put one of my keys. I still haven't done. Now, someone replied to my Gumtree ad for that boy's bike. But true to form, I never replied back. Be nice if it would sell. Because I could do with the cash. Oh well. Shit happens. I haven't got the cash, I'm just thinking it's too late to do any more on that bike. Mustn't forget I got to grease that seat post up. We'll give it a clean down with some steel wool as well. It'll help at raise and lowering the frame a bit better. Funky feeling edge on the edge of this camera. I'm actually wondering if I could convert this to caged bearings. I probably could, actually. I've got some old caged bearings. I could just try them and see if it'll work before I go out and get some new ones or whatever. There's the lock ring, but where's the cup gone? Yeah, I've just got to remember that there's a right and a wrong way to put these in. If you look, the left side, as I'm holding it, this one, is actually longer than the other side. So that's your drive side. That's what your crank's got to go on. So I've got to put it in long side first. Like that. Obviously with some bearings as well. It ain't gonna work without bearings. Well, it will, but probably not for very long. Ah, spanner. Screwdrivers. Don't really need screwdrivers in here because, well, I do, because it's a mobile toolkit, but there's plenty of screwdrivers over at Mum's in the toolbox. Bloody stacks of them. Two more spanners. Or shall I call them wrenches? Ah, what did I do with those tire levers? A couple of tire levers missing. I had them earlier because I was pissing around with my back wheel until I got pissed off with it and just left it in the shed. I could have taken the back wheel back out, brought it up here and had a look at the wheel then, but it pissed me off again, so I just put the bike in the shed and left it. Screwdriver. Being careful not to sit on poor Nemo. Should lay in there, okay. Right. Got a cover for that knife. That is in the toolbox. I know that is in there. I've got another one of these missing again. I think it's hiding in the car somewhere. I don't know where. I'm sure that's where I put it. Those pliers as well. I'll just roll Mr. Rally that way. Oh, there's the cover for the knife. That's all right then. Wait, if that knife... If that hammer's in there, then what the hell? Oh, another one up there. Forgot I had two of them small hammers. Okay. I think this might be a bit of a tight squeeze. My chain splitter, I haven't got a lot of choice. That's got to go in here. I won't go anywhere else. There's my tool from the crank extractor, which is in my hand. Knife. Top tray. Think I might invest in a toolbox a smidge bigger than this one. The next one up, I think. Because it is getting quite a chore to try and squeeze all this in here. Right, there's a knife, adjustable wrench, cutters, pliers, tray, will that go in? Oh, you see it's too high this end, I think. Oh yeah, it's far too high. Shit. Oh no. I'll leave that smaller pipe wrench out for now. That might solve the problem now. Just. Still. Isn't this poxy? It is the poxy friggin' screwdrivers, isn't it? Yeah. I think I'm going to invest in a slightly larger toolbox. Close enough. No, I can't get it to close. Hell, Ellis is getting caught on that. things, is it? I can't see anything. Sitting in there nicely. A couple of these then. That's better. I think that's better anyway. Yep, that'll do. That there. Close that. That'll do. Anything up here, have I? Nope. Just those two tire levers that are up here somewhere. They're probably on the floor down here somewhere. And take that hand pump, because I've got racing tires out there and the air compressor doesn't have an adapter for it. Back the racer up. Hopefully it won't fall over. Right. Whew. I think that's it for today's video, to be honest. So, let's turn it around. Can't think of anything else. Want to get my suspension bike done, but no. Bearings. I don't have any spares. I couldn't buy bulk from somewhere. That would make life a lot easier. Same with cables. If I could buy a bulk lot of cables. Just a bulk lot of gear cable, bulk lot of brake cable, and a bulk lot of whatever it was I said before that. I can't remember. Anyway, I'm going to disappear. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, etc., etc., etc. And I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.